Welcome back to Nashville, the Chevrolet Super Truck 100 here from the Motor City, Nashville, Tennessee. You're watching it all live on TNM Motor Madness as we continue our march through all the Friday nights here in the summertime. Guy out front having a pretty good run out there too, buddy. Roy Binkley's already picked up $500 for leading at the halfway point, but that number one Dodge, Jimmy Valentine's just sitting right back there waiting.
Just waiting is right, but you know the 25 truck there, Roy Binkley has already won this year, so he knows how to do it. It's up to Valentine to find some flaw in the way he gets around this racetrack.
He is the points leader, Roy Binkley, as they get set to come back to the green. Valentine sits 10th in the points. Everybody hanging on that bottom groove.
Absolutely, right around the bottom. You noticed that time that you didn't have, at the 25 truck gets a little bit wide there. Valentine puts a lot of heat on him on the inside.
Well, I thought he was gonna get it. Binkley recovered nicely, but he's sliding up the racetrack, isn't he? Look at him do it again there. And that one truck is running nice and tight on that bottom yellow line. Valentine, he's going to get him, buddy. It's just a matter of time because you can see Binkley's pushing up a half a lane every time.
What he's doing, though, he may be not, as you see him right there, he's not really getting up in the second lane, so he actually has the lower lane covered. If he does not do something a little more desperate in the center part of the corner and give Valentine the whole bottom part, he's got the bottom lane blocked.
Is he also saving his tires maybe a little bit by running a little bit higher?
I think so. Whoa.
The 84 truck was completely sideways, and he did a tremendous job of catching it. Darrell Brawley out of Joelton, Tennessee. Neil Sadler back GMC. And you can see he's got some handling problems. It's still dancing around on him on the backside. Let's look at this again. Watch how sideways he gets coming through the turns here.
Okay, trying to get by a lap truck there and gets up in the loose stuff. There's a lot of marble up there from tire wear, and also there's a lot of sand up there, and he just got up there in the back of the truck, jumped out from under.
Did a good job of catching it. Back up front, this fight gets hot and heavy again. Working our way towards the three-quarter mark of this one. Scheduled for 100 laps here in Nashville.
You know, you might be right. At the very start, Binkley would just run away. He had about a 15-truck length lead on the restart a while ago. You can see him wash up just a little bit. Valentine, right on the bottom of the racetrack. It seems that Dodge is hooked up pretty well.
Being very, very patient. Extended cab super trucks putting on a tremendous show. Valentine, the pole winner, 10th in points. Oh, look at this. We're stacking them up. And the 84 involved in this one, it was loose before he saved it. No saving this one. Darrell Brawley in the 84. The orange 18 gets some heavy damage as well. Ray Gann, 19th in the points, and he's going to lose a few here. And there was a few other trucks that were able to avoid this, but boy, Brawley, that 84 took a heavy hit. And it looks like we got a lot of debris laying around on the racetrack. Watch this, buddy.
Okay, you can see the 84 truck there. Oh, he had a lot of help getting down in the corner there. That's the 18 truck of Ray Gann got into him, and they started this melee. Look at the fiberglass fly as they get down in the corner there. There's some real damage to the front of these trucks.
72, John Blanks was involved. 77, John Bum works for GE up in Indiana. There you see him, the Jasper-backed machine involved. He tries to go high. It looks like he's going to get away, and then look, they all just catch up to him.
Oh, man.
93, Todd Collins up to the high side. It looks like the 81. Trying to get that other number. The 01. The other one involved in that. Ed Pruitt. We'll straighten them out. We'll start them back up. We'll get the conclusion when we come back.
When it comes to roping a steer, folks in Grand Junction, Colorado will tell you that Ron Markin can ride with the best of them. And when it comes to overhauling an engine or rebuilding a carburetor, well, he can do it all. You see, when Ron's not riding a horse for fun, he's turning a wrench for a living. So he buys a lot of parts, mostly from AutoZone. Sure, there are other parts stores in town, but Ron knows that when you want the right part for the right price, there's just no place better than AutoZone.
Just what you need, a flat. Get new Prestone Tire Jack, the premium sealer and inflator that passes the Prestone 7 nail test. It's the only one with the AcroSeal system. New Prestone Tire Jack, protection that's tough as nails.
Not everyone is a champion angler, but anyone can land the prize catch in the TNN Outdoors Big Bass and Sweepstakes. Enter today and you could hook the big one. A 5-day, 4-night fishing trip for two to beautiful Table Rock Lake at scenic Big Cedar Lodge. Plus, free admission to the Big Bass World Championship Tournament in Branson, Missouri. And if that's not enough to get you hooked, you'll also win a $25,000 shopping spree for Bass Pro merchandise. Just send in a postcard with your name, age, address, and telephone number to TNN Outdoors Big Bass and Sweepstakes, TNN Station, Post Office Box 3582, Southbury, Connecticut, 06488-3582. Five first prize winners and their guests will also fish Table Rock Lake and stay at Big Cedar Lodge. Plus, get free admission to the Big Bass World Championship Tournament. Second prize, TNN Outdoors merchandise. Enter as often as you like. Don't let this one get away. Enter now and reel in the prizes in the TNN Outdoors Big Bass and Sweepstakes.
Saturday's Journey Through the South with Wade Bourne for the best hunting and fishing spots.
All right, that's a good one there.
Southern Outdoors, Saturday mornings, 9:30 Eastern on TNN Outdoors.
TNN's Motor Madness. Katie Austin, Dave Burns hanging out here in Charlotte where all the action taking place in Nashville. We'll get back to the super trucks in a minute. We want to let you know about next week. Looking forward to this one. You'll be there.
Indianapolis, the Circle City. It's the end of the Monster Truck Series this year on Motor Madness, and they're going to crown the Kings of the Hill, both in the Pro Arena trucks and the Monster Truck. Should be great action from the Hoosier Dome there in Indianapolis.
This is the big event they've all been waiting for.
Yep, it is the big one, end of the year.
All night long.
As Motor Madness rocks Indianapolis for the Monster Truck Challenge finale. Don't move, Robbie.
I'm not going anywhere. Felix isn't going anywhere.
Because all the action hits next Friday in the final event of the year.
Hey, let's just place this over. Let's hit the reset button, go to the next track.
Ooh, can't do that. So be right here at 8 o'clock for all the high-flying action as they crash into the championship. Big time fun, Katie, in Indianapolis next week.
Is that your voice correct?
Yeah. My voice cracks a lot.
Oh, he's growing up. You know how it is. We're going back to Nashville, the super trucks are. They got a big mess out there, a lot of wrecks, a lot of trucks involved, and Ralph, I'm wondering if they're going to get that cleaned up in time for fanfare.
Katie, fanfare is not until June, but, you know, as much as they tore up around here, you're probably right. It's going to take them a while. Fanfare's a lot of fun, buddy. Have you ever been here for that?
Absolutely. Sure have, yeah.
That is one of the neatest things you get to do by being a member of TNN Motorsports staff, as Katie well knows. Steve, Chad Chafin walking around down there.
Yeah, sure is. He's going to start 13th in the Busch race tomorrow, but right now he's the acting crew chief for Brad Baker. How about it, Chad?
Yeah, we got a great young driver here we're trying to bring along. Logan's Ford Super Truck is running real good tonight, and I think they had somebody got crossed up in one of them chain reactions. He's about third in line, and the guy behind him spun him out. But we're going to come out and run the laps. We need the experience, and he's got a good truck, and he's going to come back up to the front.
Well, best of luck tomorrow, Chad. We're going green.
Thank you very much.
And Ralph, I should add, it's starting to rain a little bit down here, too. We've seen some raindrops.
Not what I wanted to hear, Steve. Not what I wanted to hear. But we're three-quarters of the way almost home, buddy. 75 laps would be the three-quarter mark. This thing would be complete.
Wow, you can see Valentine take a look on the inside in the number one truck there. Oh, he's getting a great forward bite right now, and I think Mike Alexander having that great knowledge of this racetrack certainly is a plus for Valentine.
I got to ask you, buddy, now, I know racing on an oval is not a good thing to do in the rain. How much will those treads help them at all?
Let me tell you something. You want to talk about something that bothers you. If you look up on that windshield and see that rain running up towards the top of that truck, that physically works on you. I'll tell you, and mentally, you say, I just hope it sticks. But I'm sure they're watching it right now. You can see they're not in any trouble at all. The trucks are really tracking around here quite well, so it's not enough rain to give us any problem yet.
So if you're Valentine, you really want to push hard now from second, because if you can get around them, they might throw a red. Call this one. You got to try to gain the position you can now, right?
Yeah, this isn't a dress rehearsal. It's for real right now, because you never know when the sky's going to open up and they have to put the red flag out. So, yeah, you got to give it all you got.
So the racing continues even here in the back of the pack. you take a look at the 92 fighting it out back there. David Matheny fighting it out with the 28 of Sam Robbins. Oh, look at the one truck. See how loose Valentine got?
All you have to do is overshoot that corner just a little bit, get out in the gray part of the racetrack, and away you go. Valentine was trying very, very hard, and when you try hard, sometimes you make a mistake.
Caution is coming out for Rain. That is exactly what Binkley wanted to see, not what Valentine and Carter and the rest wanted to see. We're going to have to keep our eyes on this and see. Oh, boy. You know, sitting where we are, it looked like it had been a beautiful night all night long, but I didn't realize it was getting this dark. Look at this. Watch the one truck here, buddy.
Okay, you can see him go down here. He goes in the corner very, very hard. Whoa, I'm going to tell you what. The rain might have had something to do with that, but he drove that thing nearly to China before he lifted then.
Driver's skill had a lot to do with catching it, as did luck. A lot of luck. That is a pretty looking truck, too. Nice looking piece of equipment, this Dodge. Southern Dodge Dealers Dodge. Jimmy Valentine. Dodge 1500 is the model. It's extended crew cabs. I really think those look neat, too.
I do, too, and that window opening is such a pleasure to see. One that I can get in.
Well, we are past the three-quarter mark. Of course, halfway with 50 laps would have made this a complete race. We're waiting to see what the track will do, what the rain will do. Here's a look at the top 10. What will this do to the Busch race tomorrow as well, buddy?
Well, it's going to wash the racing surface off, and, you know, it depends on how much clear sky we have tomorrow, whether they start on completely a green racetrack. Of course, if we have good weather up to then, they'll get out, they'll qualify the second round and the whole bit. But right now, this will clean the racetrack down, wash all the oil and rubber off the racetrack, and, yeah, it'll change the complexion of the race surface for tomorrow.
Steve, how's it doing out there?
Yeah, I'm down in Roy Binkley's pits, and it's not too bad at this end of the racetrack. We're near turn one, but Roy has called into the crew and said 3 and 4 is very slick. He said he's is pretty dangerous right now, so we don't know if they're going to get back underway or not.
Well, hopefully we'll be able to complete this thing under green flag conditions.
What was that noise that Katie made a while ago right after the turkey call? Yeah, the duck call. I guess that's what it was. I
think she had something to do with this, huh?
Well, I don't know. I know what ducks like. We're getting some of it.
Yeah. This is not positive for race fans. We can tell you, though, that this is not the only racing you're going to see here on TNN this weekend. Of course, they'll be back out here tomorrow, rain permitting, of course, weather permitting, to run the 320 lapper here for the Busch cars. Buddy Baker, Steve Burns, Mike Hogwood, and Mike Joy is going to take over the controls for this one. And of course, myself and Dave Burns are going to be making our way down to Jefferson, Georgia, Peach State Speedway for Sunday afternoon, where we will have an ASA race live on TNN on Sunday in the Trans Am series and the trucks out in Phoenix. We'll have that for you as well on Sunday. So make sure you stay tuned to TNN Motorsports all weekend long for your live racing action. Well, guess what, buddy?
Yeah, it looks like Roy Binkley may have a win here.
The red and the checkers getting set to wave. Binkley, who leads the points, already has one win, picks up his second win here at the Nashville Speedway. As the checker and the red flag wave in the hands of Chuck Rice, the flagman, and Roy Binkley picks up the win. Kippy is happy, and you know Steve's happy because he gets to interview her again, I'm sure, knowing Burns.
Yeah, it is indeed my pleasure. Kippy, you are the sponsor. Your brother comes home a winner.
Well, I taught him everything he knows. What can I say? He followed my instructions, and he did well.
Yes, he did. Congratulations.
We'll take a rain out. But, yeah, he was doing real well. The car was running great. He was driving well. Thankfully, no one was hurt during the race, which is very important. So, feels great to be in victory lane.
And I want to thank you for the hug earlier.
My pleasure. Really.
Thank you, Kippy.
Thank you.
I'm sure Steve will make sure Kippy stays nice and warm and dry. Roy Binkley, the winner. Jimmy Valentine gets second. Alan Carter is credited with third. Dale Buskell is fourth. Ricky Haynes is fifth. We're not done yet. Stay with us. We'll come back, rain or shine.
Unleash the Performance, it's my job. You need the right technology. You need the right skills. You need the right equipment. You need the right gasoline. And you need the right motor oil.
You need to use your 9-iron. Good thing he can drive.
Citgo says, go.
I cannot live another day without air conditioning.
Says tomorrow's gonna be hotter.
Hotter?
Like yesterday.
Yesterday? Yesterday you said you'd call Sears.
I'll call today.
You call now.
I'll call now.
Now's the time to save on Sears installed central air conditioning. Get 0% finance charge, no billing, and no payments until July with the Sears Charge Home Improvement Plan. Call now for a free in-home estimate on a Kenmore air conditioning system. State-of-the-art engineering means greater energy efficiency. A new Kenmore could save 10 to 44% on your annual cooling costs. In time, even pay for itself. Sears also offers fast emergency installation, a 5-year warranty on parts and labor, plus our satisfaction guarantee. And you know Sears will be there to back it up. Get 0% finance charge, no billing, no payments until July. Offer ends April 30th. So call now and save with Sears.
So what's the paper say about tomorrow?
Another scorcher.
Cool.
On the next Hot Rod TV, new high-performance induction for a classic old Chevelle as we swap its stock car for a high-performance electronic fuel injection system. So hang on for Hot Rod TV this weekend on TNN Motorsports.
Roy Binkley, the winner here tonight in Nashville. Let's go down and meet him. He's with Steve Burns.
Hey, Ralph. Roy, well, I tell you what, that number one truck gave you all you could handle, but you held him off.
I tell you, he's tough. He's strong at Dodge Motors, making a lot of power, but his Chevrolet wasn't too bad tonight on Chevrolet night. And I just want to thank Duraliner Truck Accessories, the Deflector Shield, Ken Binkley Signs, Shy Racing Shocks, Fleet Painting, Centos. I tell you what, all these Keith Batson and all these guys put on a good show. And put me right here.
You forgot your sister, your other sponsor.
Hey, I saved the best for last. Hey, now my sister's doing an excellent job singing her new CD, I'd Be With You. Everybody needs to go out and buy one, celebrate this victory.
All right, let's go back upstairs. Congratulations.
Well, don't worry about it, Roy. Steve will promo her anyway. Chevy Supertruck 100, here's a look at the top 10. As we get to head out of here and head back to Charlotte, I want to thank Steve Burns, my good buddy, Buddy Baker. Best of luck to you. Enjoy Talladega. You earned it. Back to Katie and Dave in the studios in Charlotte.
Guys, as usual, Ralph Sheen and Buddy Baker, a great job. Buddy, you're in your prime out there, and a way to go for his Hall of Fame induction to the Motorsports Hall of Fame this Thursday in Talladega. Congratulations.
Yep, congratulations, Buddy. Now, Katie, I've always wondered, racing at night in Nashville, why they look so much faster. I mean, this week I went out and I checked with a physicist, I checked with a psychologist, and I wanted to know more about it. So I went out to Charlotte Motor Speedway to find out for myself. So I asked myself, why? Why is it that racing under the lights, racing in the glow of moonlight, racing when the sun goes down seems so much faster, somehow better, more exciting, gets me wild, and I mean really wild, a sort of craziness, a motor madness, if you like. So I asked my friend Mark Martin, what is the reason for this phenomenon of sight and mind? Is it psychological? What is the scientific principle behind my quest?
I don't have any idea. Do you?
No, I do not. So I went to my friend Ted, and I said, Ted, I want you to put me in the car and show me that it's faster under the lights so that I may experience it the way you do, the way you've seen it for years, under the lights, faster than daytime, circling the oval, touring the speedway. And while we're out here, tell me, is it a question of motion perception, or is it simply sensation, Ted? Is it memory, expectation, motivation, and attention, or is my brain dictating perceptual vigilance or perceptual censoring, whereby it sees only what it wants to see, and what my mind wants to perceive is cars going faster and faster when they're under the lights? Is that it?
That's the only explanation I know, but
I am not convinced. So I said, thank you, Mark. Thank you, Ted. Thank you, Mr. Mutton and Musgrave, but I must discover the answer for myself. I must put on the suit. I must select the helmet. I must wear it and wear it proudly. I must put on the gloves and drive the car myself. I must drive and drive and drive under the lights, around the high bank, circling the speedway, touring the oval to discover the answer to my question, to your question, to our question.
Sorry, Katie, I've been a little bit busy.
Why is it faster at night, under the light, shrouded in the cloak of darkness, surrounded by moonlight blue? And does it really matter when we consider how extraordinary it is to see motor madness taking place under the lights?
We don't even know the answer.
We never really did find out the answer. Sorry. But
what was the speed? What?
It was not as fast as some others.
I drove faster on the way to the airport, okay?
Sorry. Hey, Katie, we have to say that Valvoline invited us to do that for part of their promotions. Get in touch with Valvoline about winning an actual Mark Martin race car this fall.
Oh, no. We'll have a great time next week. Join us on TNN's Motor Madness for you Friday night. See you then.
Motor Madness is brought to you by Milwaukee's Best. When you're looking for a different breed of beer, unleash the beast. Lighting for tonight's event provided by Musco International. Drivers, race teams, and race fans, the 1997 Simpson Race Products Catalog is now available, featuring all the new products and services for 97, plus Simpson's complete line of racer and fan gear. To get your copy, call 1-800-71-RACIN and join Team Simpson today. Go behind the scenes with Ernie Irvin in the exclusive video documenting his triumphant return to racing. Gladiator and Universal Luxury Vans, the official van of tracks, teams, and drivers throughout the NASCAR world. Call 1-800-445-2825 for a dealer near you. By Featherlight Trailers, the official trailer of NASCAR, IndyCar, IRL, and major sponsor of the NHRA. Remember to call Featherlight for all your trailer needs at 1-800-800-1230 or 319-547-6000.